everyone, it's Alexis from Sims VIP. I hope you're all doing well. Welcome to the Deliciously Indulgent Bakery video overview. So, the Sims 3 store team just released a brand new business style venue. I don't even know where to begin with this one because I'm in love with it. It's basically a bakery venue, so your Sims have like display cases and all this like racks and stuff like that where they can basically set up any type of food business they want. I know that with Midnight Hollow, we had gotten the Savvy Sellers collection, which allowed you to basically sell almost every object in build buy mode, except for some things. So they had covered that aspect with Midnight Hollow, but then this covers the rest of it. You know, for those of you that might have been like, oh, I wish we could sell recipes, stuff like that. Well, this is the set that will let you do that. My original plan was to just come on here, make a little quick note and be like, just go buy it because it's that great. I love it. I'm fangirling over this set. But I wanted to at least give you guys a look at what this set includes. So, for starters, there is no creative sim stuff, so you're not getting anything there. There are some new build and buy objects, which I'll show you. And then it comes with the Deliciously Indulgent Bakery Hangout. Well, I made it a hangout. You can basically call your community lot whatever you want. It is a hangout. I'm just confusing myself. I named the community lot something else. But anyways, so it comes with this venue. The venue has everything inside. There's like different bakeries in there, all these different little areas where they look like baker stations, stuff like that. It comes, you can find it in the community lot bin. It's a 30 by 30 lot. Go ahead and place it anywhere in town. I am still playing in East La Prairie, but I think another good one for this would be Monte Vista. I think the style of that world would fit this very well. So basically this set comes with some brand new recipes, but it also enables you to use recipes from other sets that you may have or expansions. And then on top of it, you can basically sell anything that your Sims can cook in this. It's really a go all out. You can basically cook and put whatever you want for sale. I know that Cinderella Mouse on Twitter made a deli, which was really cool. She had like eggs and cheese and hot dogs and a bunch of like different stuff, which you can basically make anything you want. You can ultimately make a cheese store. You can make a tomato store, a cucumber store, you know, stuff like that. Anything that your Sims can, you know, possibly make. Can go into this lot. So there it is. I just placed it down in my world. And we're gonna hop in and check it out. First, I'm going to place my pre-made little check somewhere here. Yeah, whatever. That's fine. And we'll check it out. If you guys check out the description below, I actually have a link to the write-up I did on SimsVIP.com. You guys can go there and check out in detail all the items that came with the set, some pictures, and a couple videos that I did that I threw up before, and a full list of recipes, because I'm definitely not going to be going through every single recipe in here. So let me lower this down a little bit. Let's go over and take a look at the bakery. So this is actually a really well done bakery. I think it's a little crammed because they literally like crammed everything into one venue. But this is it. I mean, it looks like it's a really nice venue. I like it. Me personally, this set is like a dream come true. So I have nothing but good to say about it. I don't care if somebody wants to call me a crazed Sims 3 person. Yes, I am. You know, just a lot of things in this venue looks really, really gorgeous. There's multiple levels. There's like little areas here. Look at the clutter, these baguettes and like a, you know, fake pie and a flour sack and all this stuff. I mean, they basically make it look like it's a little baker station. And in this set comes the premium content, which is this oven here. It only serves, you can only create a certain type of food objects. You know, you can't just make anything off of this. And since ovens can't go on in community lots, you basically have to make whatever else you want at home and then bring it quickly and put it on the racks if you want to. So a little bit of work there, but you know, I'm sure if you check out the official forums, there might be someone there who's possibly found a better way, like, you know, having a genie in your household that can summon the perfect quality of any food. You can do something like that. Also, which is another good thing, is that there's a cheat that's associated with this oven that lets you just spawn out any type of recipe you want that's available from it. So we'll go into detail on this in a little bit, but I wanted you guys to check out this venue. Really cool. I mean, there's like another little area here. This is basically what it looks like. It looks like a little bistro, something you would see in like Italy, I guess. Really, really cute. And these are the little bakeries. Look at them. They're so adorable. Look at this. Ah, they have Hi. What happened here? You know, if there's one thing I always wanted to complain about with Sims 3 is the camera. Really annoys me. I really hope that changes in Sims 4. Okay, so we have three bakeries here. There's a bunch of new recipes. For example, there is a new birthday cake. And yes, you can blow out the candles. You can use it as a regular birthday cake and a wedding cake, which, you know, if you're getting married, you can cut the cake and so on. There's pies, there's cobbler, cinnamon rolls, all kinds of different cookies, cupcakes, cobblers. I mean, they went all out on this. And there's a lot of new recipes included. But at the same time, you can actually enable other recipes by having other sets installed, which we'll get into when we get to that part. So this is basically what you're looking at, is the venue. It's so cute. I like how it's set up. Again, I know you guys know this already. Look, bread. I know you guys for a fact know that I'm not a builder. So you know I love new venues. I can't build. This is perfect. I'm sure the community will build something, you know, great too. But I love official lots. Always love them. So definitely something for those of you out there who don't want to spend your time doing nothing but building and then having no time to play. So yeah, there's like a little courtyard out here with tables and stuff like that. A lot of integration with other sets included with this. You could do a lot, which we'll get into. So that was a quick look at the venue, which is awesome. I like it. If there was a way for me to squee without sounding ridiculous on camera, I would squee. So let's go back to the house. I'm going to show you guys a couple of the items that you can find in build by mode. Note that I do have other sets in here just so that I can show you the different cross set features that come with some of the other stuff in the store. So just keep that in mind. Let me give her some money. Oh no, mother lewd. Okay. The baker station, which is the premium content that I showed you guys in the store. There's a couple other things too in here. Here we go. Here is the delightfully dessert display. This display and then the racks that come with it, as well as some carpets. They're basically like they keep your food refrigerated, quote unquote, like some in stas, you know, like basically like nothing's going to expire as long as they're in these cases. So you don't have to worry about everything you've made going bad in a couple of hours. Same goes with the bakery rack. What is this? This is not part of it. No. So those are the two new, you know, that's where you're going to put all the stuff that you're going to sell as far as food goes. Okay, nothing in here. This is the Sweet Nothing Simoleon Register. This is another premium content that actually enables you to sell everything that you make. So, it you know, obviously the register comes with the set. It's like all in one, two separate premium contents. But who knows if they're ever going to just, you know, separate this stuff in the store. But basically, you need this in order to sell anything, but you don't need it to create anything, if that makes sense. This is the new wedding cake and the birthday cake that you can buy in buy mode, for you to have around the house. So if your Sims got a birthday coming up, you know, feel free to add one to your house or the wedding cake, whatever you're doing. And then let's head into the decor area. There's some, you know, like a flower sack, really cute, you know, clutter, which I love. The perfect plastic pie, you can throw a couple of those. The handy cookie jar, there's different cookie jars. There's like chocolate chip, sugar cookies, and like chocolate cookies or something. There's baguettes in a bucket. let's see. The special street sign. So like, you know, those little things that can complete the look if you're planning on building your own. What else do we have in here? Oh, La Fantasie Baker's sign. So they have like a lot of signs and awnings and stuff for builders to put on the outside. Another wall sign. Here's another awning that you can put outside your bakery. And then here are the bakery sales rugs. There's two different sizes. And basically, if you, let's say for example, like there's some recipes that you can't fit into the display cases or on the racks because they just don't go in there. You can put these rugs and then put a counter on top of the rug and then put the actual food on top of the counter and then it'll stay. It's the same as it being inside of the display case or the rack, so it keeps your food, you know, good. And then let's see, what else do we have here? I don't think there's anything else. There may or may not be anything in build mode. I don't remember. I don't think so. No, that's basically it. Yeah, I'm looking here at like my papers and stuff that I had. I do not see anything. Oh, actually, yes, there are windows. Windows. So let me sort these really quick. Yeah, there's a couple windows here. So there's like, you know, they look like bakery, you know, like poster in a window. And then this one's like a dessert window, something you'd see, you know, like, oh, desserts here. But that is all that there is as far as build and buy mode. I think there's like 22 items total as far as build and buy mode goes. So not a lot, but enough. I guess the premium content is what drives the price up to the 1900 sim points. So what's that like? Almost $20. So I don't know. I personally think that even though they didn't do a sale on it, I like it. The price is okay with me. This is something that I've been waiting for forever. You know, the Savvy Sellers collection from Midnight Hollow was a step in the right direction, but I honestly thought that was it. That was like the best we were going to get. And you couldn't even sell any recipes. So it's like really like you can't even make your own business, you know, selling food, which I love to do. I love the whole gardening and cooking aspect in the game. So this is great. All right, now let's, let me see here how I'm going to continue this. I want to make sure I cover everything with you guys. So, all right, this is what we're going to do. I am going to head over to the bakery again, the venue. And I want to show you guys all the different recipes that come with it and what you can make if you have a couple other expansions and sets installed in the game. All right, let's go over here. Okay, so your Sims can automatically, like, let's say you didn't have anything but the base game and you know, this set, right? You'll be able to make 14 brand new recipes, so that don't require anything. There are like a total of like 40, I think it's like 40 or 38 new recipes you can make from this oven, but only 14 of them if you actually only have this set and base game. So you can make apple cobbler. So like if you go here and you say serve, you know, there's a bunch, you'll see a lot of things here that you might not see, but that's because it requires a specific set or expansion. But here's what you can make. Apple cobbler, apple pie, the birthday cake, cinnamon rolls, dinner rolls, which is like in the bread area. You can make dinner rolls, white bread. You can make peanut butter cookies. You can make oatmeal raisin cookies. You can make cupcakes. You can make the wedding cake. You can make a baguette. And then you can also create the life fruit pie. Which is something that came, where is it? More, here we go. Life fruit. Oh no. I think you have to have the life fruit in you have to have the life fruit in your inventory for it to show up here. Because life fruit's not considered something you can just purchase. It's something that's like rare. So but yeah, you'd have to have it in your inventory for it to show up, but that's part of it. So they all have different cooking skill levels, so it's not like your sim can make everything at once. The ones that you see here that are highlighted for me to select are ones that don't require any specific cooking skill levels. So the ones that are there, you know, are good to go. As your sim gains skill, they can make more and more of the standard. Now, if your sim has the harvest stands, which is actually the little fruit stand where they could sell fruits from the stand, that it also included it. I think it included lemons and eggplants, I think. Yeah, lemons and eggplants. And then the Bohemian Garden introduced like strawberries, blueberries, blackberries, pecans, nuts, like a bunch of nuts and fruits. It was just recently released a couple weeks ago. So if you have harvest stands, Bohemian Garden, World Adventures, which brought in like the plums, the pomegranates, the wood fire oven from Monte Vista will actually unlock new breads. If you have Grandpa's Grove, that had oranges, so you can make, I believe it was an orange pie or something you can make. Okay, I guess the game's stuck. Here it is. Serve orange pie. Yeah, orange pie. So The Sims 3 World Adventures, you can get like the plum pie, the cherry cobbler, stuff like that, pomegranate pie. And what else? The Sims 3 Late Night, plasma cobbler and plasma, I think it's pie. Oh, no, not plasma pie. Plasma cobbler. Yes, plasma cobbler. So if you have certain expansions, like I said earlier, check out the link below. I have everything listed there for you so you can see exactly what you're getting with what sets installed. But they basically added and unlocked a ton of new recipes for you. So, you know, there's like the pear cobbler, chocolate pie, strawberry pie, raspberry pie, peach pie, pear pie, plum cobbler, wheat bread, raspberry cobbler, orange pie, banana cream pie. Actually, that one is standard. It comes with it because I've actually had a few people on the website who commented and said they don't have Showtime installed and they do have the option to make banana cream pie. So that one's also one of the standard ones. And then there's blueberry pie, cherry cobbler, pecan pie, sourdough bread, blackberry pie, cherry pie, rye bread, plasma cobbler, blueberry cobbler. So like I said, check out the link below. I got everything there. So you're talking massive amounts of recipes here. You could see all the breads back here. You got, you know, sourdough, you got your baguette, you got your dinner rolls, you have the white bread, you have the wheat bread, you know, cinnamon rolls, all kinds of different pies here, cookies, cobblers, the works. This oven unlocks all kinds of things, which is amazing because I own all the other sets. Some people don't own them also, but you still get 15 new recipes, which is really, really cool because I think that's like the most we've ever gotten. We didn't even get that many in expansions, I don't think, unless like Seasons and University with their little, the kiosks and the festival grounds and stuff like that, if that added anything in the cafeteria on University. But I mean, this is a lot, so I'm not complaining because I love to cook. I love to do everything. So those recipes are the only ones you can make from this oven. Obviously, you can go home, make other ones, and bring them right over here to store them and sell them. So the whole concept of this is, you know, you can sell everything from this baker's oven, which is enabled for community lots, or you can make anything you want. Let's say you go and buy cheese from the grocery store. You can put them in here and make a deli. It's like, it's really, you can create anything you want. You can make just a bread store. You can make just a cupcake store, just a cake store. Granted, there's only two cakes you can make, but if you just wanted to have a cake store, you can do that. Just so much that you can do on this. It's awesome. Now, obviously, like I said, without the register, you can't sell anything. You know, you can set hours for the lots. You can tend to the register yourself. You can hire a sales clerk. You can check sales performance. Just, you know, to see how everything's going. People will come in and they will purchase these things. Like, unlike the Savvy Sellers Collection, even I had problems getting anybody to buy something. I don't know what the problem was with it, but it took like a day to sell like 10 items. Or like 5 days to sell 10 items. So this, then another thing that's different about this is your Sims have to restock everything. It does not automatically stock. So if people are coming in here and, you know, they're looking to buy things, you either have to, you know, cook it yourself and put it back in there, or, you know, I don't know what you're going to do, summon a genie, you know, and have him cook everything or her. But yeah, basically you have to restock it. So that means that you cannot have an NPC run bakery, meaning you can't just like there won't be competition really, because nobody else around town, if you put a couple more, will restock. So NPCs cannot run these. However, there is another way for you to get that done. Let's say, for example, you had the if you have the industrial oven, which was like the oven that made a lot, like a restaurant where your Sims could go and, you know, purchase something off of the menu, anything in game, you can make like your own restaurant. If you have that set installed, you can make a restaurant with only certain items. Granted, you're not cooking it, you're not this, you know, it's run by the NPCs, but who cares, because you can make your, like, you can literally make a bread restaurant if you wanted to. You could really do that, which I think is really cool. This set is something different, unlike anything I've seen before. I'm so excited for it. I've been wanting something like this since The Sims 2. So, all right, we'll have some people come in here. I'm pretty sure that your Sim has to own the lot in order to profit from it. I want to say I'm 100% sure, but I can't. We'll see as we go. But I'm going to have her come over here, and I'm going to have her bake a birthday cake.
Lena! Meska! Mejaloo! Blurp!
I love the fake interactions, like they're actually putting the stuff in there, mm-hmm. and then it'll just disappear. She like licked the spoon. She was like, oh, not bad. Huh? All right. Look, she touches the oven with her bare hands.
Zaggy.
I'm going to speed it up a little.
Ew. Ah. Oh.
And this is a cute little moodlet she got, just like Mom used to make. The smell of fresh baked bread in the morning, even though we're making a cake or whatever. I guess it's still... So it comes out like very plain, and she's actually going to frost it, which is, I mean, it adds the finishing touches on this set. I love it. So it's going to turn in... There we go. Ta-da! And she'll go and put it somewhere and lay it on the side. So let's pretend, let's have her tend to the register. Let's see who comes in. You know, as you can see, like, people are, like, here and they're, like, browsing. Somebody obviously bought some bread because I think there was one up here. But, yeah, let's check this out.
Mommy, nah.
Must not be very good quality because nobody likes anything.
Good Uncle Bronk.
Splart!
Mila? Kasha?
No!
So yeah, like, you'll have people coming into the store and stuff. Let's see, I wonder if they'll buy anything. You know, I did the other video and somebody came in and bought everything at once.
Baja.
And from the register, you can do all kinds of things. Set hours. And then if you go to the individual... like racks or anything, you can set a markup. You can obviously purchase directly from it.
Lord.
Set a sale. So, like, let's, you know, let me do a 75% discount on everything. Let's see if anybody buys anything.
Ooh, Ibi. Oh.
I made 10 bucks.
Cheap.
We bought some.
That's all neat.
Oh, four.
Jerky.
See, this is why I don't think you need to own it. Maybe you don't. Oh my god, I thought you did.
Is the bubble?
Zepto Nissan Ta.
Not that many people bought stuff today. This guy just like literally went in. He went and got like a juice pack or something. A paparazzi's following. I really wish they wouldn't come behind the corner. I don't know what she's saying. Oh, there's cupcakes missing. Somebody bought cupcakes. You'd think with 75% off, they'd buy it no matter how like, crappy it was. I mean, aren't these like perfect quality? They're like perfect quality. This guy's like cooking stuff. Like, hi, thank you. I'm glad you came into my store. Is this like lemon meringue pie? Oh no, I think that's the banana cream pie. I wonder what he's making. He's making like a cobbler. Ugh. Oh. I froze my game. No. No, no, no. There we go. I think he made a cobbler. Oh, my sim went home to, like, pee. Ooh, he made, like, a... I wonder what this is. Let's see. Raspberry, maybe? Come on. This always happens when I forward my game. I don't know why. Speed up, I mean. Strawberry cobbler. Yummy. Look at that. Looks pretty good. I don't know. Is anybody really like... I don't think anybody's buying anything. What is this? When I was doing the other video, they like wiped me out completely. I don't know. This is weird. Everything's for sale. Oh, here we go again with the freezing. I have to do a little something really quick to take care of this issue. Oh, where's my city hall? Here it is. Sorry, I got to do a little cleansing of the town. Okay, so yeah, while that's happening, I just need to clear out some things so it can run a little smoother. We're going to go to the house, and I'm going to have her actually make something, I don't know, like mac and cheese. And I'm going to take it to the venue so you could see... that you can, you know, you can actually literally make anything you want, buy anything you want, and display it. So first thing we'll do is I'll have her make some mac and cheese, and then we'll go over to the grocery store and buy a few things. So let's go in here. Let's see. Does she even, yes, she has a stove. Serve dinner. And obviously they have to be servings, I think. I mean, maybe you can make an individual plate too, I guess. I'm not sure. But let's have her... make this. Yay, now we're not freezing. Hooray. Little things that mods do for your game. Alright, so I'm going to have her put it down. Let's, now you're going to take it and put it right into your Sims inventory. And then that way it's there. So we're going to have to hurry up and take it there. So I'm going to take it there now so that... it doesn't expire inside of her inventory. It's probably not the best of quality, but you literally come here, you can remove it, and bam, right onto the shelf. Now, because, or is this one not on a rug? This is weird. I don't know. Some of these things were like being very difficult. It can't go in there. It can't go in here. It can only go on the shelves. So basically what you would have to do in this situation would be you'd have to put the rugs down so that whatever was on there would be, let's see, I wonder, can she, no, it says grabbable, blow out candles. Let's see, the cinnamon roll. See, that one says buy cinnamon roll. I wonder, buy mac and cheese. There we go. This one is a dishwasher, I think. So the rug wasn't under there, but this one has a rug. So yeah, you can literally buy the mac and cheese. Now I'm going to take her out to the grocery store and I want her to purchase just like random items, because I saw that Cinderella Mouse had all these really cool things inside of hers, so I want to, let's check it out. I want to see what you can buy and fit into those display cases. I'm going to use a cheat to actually get in there and, hold on, just testing cheats. Testing cheats enabled. True. I'm going to actually cheat to edit the lot, and that's just so that I can, you know, see if it works. I can't build one, so sorry. Ooh, the oranges, so awesome. The peaches, the pears, let's see. Like, I'm just really curious to see if we can actually go and throw all this in, unless she used the cheat, but I don't think she did. So, let's head over here. Okay, this one has the display cases, so this is what I want to do. I'm going to purchase on this lot. I'm going to go back here and I'm going to remove some of these things. Oh, can't delete. We'll just move them out for right now. Okay, I'm going to have my sim come, or I can use their inventory. Let's see. Look at this. Yes! You can, oh my god, you know what this means, right? You can actually make a produce. Like, you can make a produce shop. Like, you can literally sell fruits and vegetables. This is amazing. Oh, I'm glad I, like, just figured this out in the middle of the video. But how, oh my goodness, how cool is that? You can make a fruit shop, like a grocery store. Wow, oh my god, this is awesome. So not only can you go and buy things and grow vegetables and fruits and stuff and sell them, but then you can also make things at home and bring them there. How freaking cool is this? Okay, I'm going to, let's see. All right, teleport me here. Let's see, purchase, right? Okay, purchase. This says specifically to okay, I think there's, okay, hire sales clerk. If there's a sales clerk, I think you can actually purchase directly from it anything that's in the entire store. So let me see. Set hours for lot. 11 a.m. Oh, no. Where are we? 1 a.m. Let's see. I think it's closed. That's why she's not here. Oh, there she is. Okay. Your sim is too tired. Okay, you know what? Okay. Energy bar. Okay. Purchase. Okay, so if you go directly to the register, anything that's inside the entire bakery that you have is what you can purchase. So these are going to pop up. Oh, another thing about the Savvy Sellers collection. If you have the door that came with it where you can set custom hours for continuously throughout the night, you can put one of the doors on here and then make your own hours. Because obviously the register here only allows you. Oh my good. Somebody just came and wiped out everything. What is this? Oh my god. What happened? Everything's gone from the bakery. Everything. Is this some kind of glitch? And here I thought that people were coming to buy everything. Whoa, hold on a second here. Or is it closed and it's almost like you can't see anything that's there? What? This is crazy. Open up, let's see. Hours, 8 a.m. so somebody can come to work. This is crazy. It literally wiped out everything. I don't get it. Am I to assume that some rich person came in here and bought my entire stock? I don't think so. Huh. That's really weird. That's what happened in my video, and I thought somebody came in and bought everything. Huh. Okay. Well, I'm going to have her go to the register and purchase. Okay, seriously, stop getting stuck in a corner. Purchase. Really? Why? Ugh, these routing issues. Is this some kind of joke? Okay, I'm getting rid of this table because that might be an issue. Okay, what is wrong with it? We have zero items available to purchase. You can now you can buy now or take a look around before you just like keep an eye out for discount tags. Zero items. So what? You can't put the fruits and vegetables in there then? I don't get it. Oh, okay. I guess. I guess you can display them. I guess you can display them in there, but you can't sell them then. Unless what? Unless maybe they go. What if they go like up here? You can't. You can't purchase it? I don't get this. Okay, so maybe you can't for certain items. Okay, I'm gonna take a wild guess and say you can't do fruits and vegetables. Okay, fine. So ultimately, I guess you can't make your own produce center, but you can display them and pretend that you are, I guess. They have nothing for sale. Let's see here. All right. Now, here's something I wanted to show you guys before. Now, let's say you wanted to save some time. If you're in build mode and you control shift click the oven, you can basically spawn anything. Any recipe at all. So as you can see, I just spawned this plum cobbler and it's in the display case ready for sale. So if you don't want to spend time, you know, having your Sims like slave, you can, this is exactly what you can do. So it's either that or a genie. Other than that, you're just, you know, unless you want like a night shift here cooking all, you know, night, but I don't think NPCs can do it. So you'd have to have some like family members sitting here all night cooking and setting everything up for the next day. I find it highly bizarre that everything left my game in the middle of the night. I don't know what to say about that. Very odd. But yeah, so this is basically what you know, what this entire set is all about. It's pretty cool, nice way for you to make some money, get something going, and basically have your own personalized business. Let's see here. A couple other notes I wanted to make. You can actually create the business at your house, but you have to invite Sims over in order to buy them. It's exactly like the Savvy Sellers collection. So if you can do this at home, but you have to invite everybody there. No one will automatically come to your house. In order to profit, obviously, you'll need to buy the property that the bakery is placed in. Like I said earlier, the stock will not automatically replace, as you see here. And that also means that NPCs will not be running bakeries. So there's that. There's the cheat I told you guys about. Now, let's say, for example, you own the like teppanyaki grill from the Japanese or Chinese, I don't know, whatever, Japanese set from the Sims 3 store that makes like sushi and stuff. You can actually put that in a lot and make another restaurant out of it. So, you know, you can add those to community lots, which, you know, you can basically expand an entire lot and have all kinds. You can basically make like a mall, you know, where you can have like a bakery on one place, a fruit market in another, a pie shop in another, you know, and Chinese food or Japanese food in another. Really cool. And then another awesome thing, like I said earlier, the industrial oven, it adds all the new recipes to the menu, so your Sims can go in there and order off the menu. So you can make, like I said, an all bread shop or an all cookie shop or all cupcake shop, whatever you want to do. They can order it directly from there. And last but not least, if you have the barrier to entry system, which came with the, like, what was it called? The theater venue. If you have that barrier system, you can lock the lot for only specific Sims. So let's say you have the Sims 3 late night and you want to make a vampire only restaurant and sell nothing but plasma pie. You can do that with the barrier entry system. So while you need to expand like your sets that you own in order to incorporate them all together, I still think it's awesome that they did all that and, you know, cross set features and everything, because for those of us that do have it, you can basically create the ultimate restaurant slash bakery slash business, really. So, yeah, this is basically everything. I'd like to continue playing more. And I do have mods in my game, so I think that is why everything disappeared overnight. I don't know why. That was highly bizarre. But yeah, basically, this is it. This is what you could do. I would highly recommend it. I think that this is probably one of the only sets in the Sims 3 store that I would say, you know, if you have to and you have some extra money, you seriously go get it. This will add a lot of fun aspects to the game, especially because you can create your own business properly with recipes and food. How often do you get to do that? So if I had anything else to say about it, I have to thank the gurus and the store team because I really love this set. This is something beyond awesome, something that I've been waiting for since The Sims 2 business expansion. You know, I really do hope that in The Sims 4 that they do create proper grocery stores and stuff like that from the get-go so that our Sims can go in like they did in Sims 2 and walk around with a little shopping cart, you know, basket in their hand and purchase everything. So let's see. I think I pretty much covered everything, so that's it. Now, just for fun, because I don't think I've ever done a giveaway on YouTube before, so I'm going to do it. It's a first. I'm actually going to give you guys a chance to win this set. Go ahead. You got to leave a comment below in comments. You know, make sure you're a subscriber of The Sims VIP on YouTube. You know, leave a comment down below, anything you want, and I'm going to gift a random person. It would be a good idea for you to tell me your Sims 3 username in that comment. So go ahead, leave a comment with your Sims 3 username, and I'm going to give one of you the set for free. So I'm going to gift one of you. It's going to be random. I'll be sure to, you know, make a comment here and let you guys know, or in the description, I'll go ahead and announce the winner there. But go ahead, leave a comment. Make sure you're a subscriber. You have to be a subscriber, and you got to leave me a comment with your Sims 3 username, and I'm going to pick one of you to gift. The gift, I'll pick somebody within the next, like, 48 hours. So by Tuesday, let's see here. I got to open up my calendar here because I don't know what day I'm in. By the 8th. By Tuesday the 8th, you have that long to leave a comment below. So make sure you subscribe and leave a comment with your Sims 3 username. One of you is going to get this set for free. I hope you guys enjoyed this overview. I know I love this set, so if you can, go out and get it. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching, and we'll talk later. Bye, guys.